Hi, today I want to explain the paper An Image is Worth 16 by 16 Words by Dosovitskiy and colleagues. This paper introduces vision transformer and tries to replace CNNs with transformer architecture for computer vision tasks. Transformer architecture revolutionized natural language processing. It has been used in many state-of-the-art models and has replaced the RNNs that once dominated the field. The reason for this gradual shift from RNNs to transformers was that transformers were significantly faster than RNNs because they could do parallel computations, something RNNs are incapable of. The transformer architecture has been employed in a variety of applications. Other than NLP, transformer has been used in speech recognition and some other tasks as well. Image processing, on the other hand, was a difficult domain for transformer to operate in. The reason is transformers heavily use self-attention, and self-attention is really computation-hungry. Consider this simple three-word sentence. Using each word as the query, we should calculate an attention weight between that word and every word in the sentence. Which means, for a three-word sentence like this example, we will have to calculate 9 attention weights. And for a n-word sentence, we will have to find n squared attention weights. As you can see, the computational complexity of self-attention is quadratic. Now, if we want to do the same thing in an image, we should calculate an attention weight for each possible pair of pixels, which means for an ordinary selfie like one you can see here, which has about 8 million pixels, we should calculate more than 60 trillion attention weights. Even for simpler images, like handwritten digits in MNIST dataset, which are 28 by 28 pixel images, we'll have to calculate more than 600,000 attention weights. We need to find out a way to reduce the amount of times we have to do the self-attention operation if we want to use transformer for images. To overcome this problem, researchers tried several methods. For example, instead of applying self-attention globally, they applied it exclusively in local neighborhoods for each query pixel. Convolutions could be totally replaced by such local multi-head dot product self-attention blocks. The vision transformer model presented in this paper seeks to be as close to the original transformer model as possible. In this model, we first split each image into fixed-size patches. We then take each patch, flatten it into a vector, and then use a trainable matrix E to transform flattened image linearly, resulting in a new vector that we call patch embedding. Along with patch embeddings, we also create a new trainable class token. This token works just like the CLS token in BERT. It can be used to classify the image. But before we send these embeddings into the transformer encoder, we should consider the fact that transformer doesn't know anything about the order and position of its inputs. So, these two images in this slide are identical to a transformer. Therefore, we have to somehow inform our model about the position of each patch. Just like the original transformer, here we can simply add a positional encoding to our patch embedding to include special information. For each position, there is a learnable positional encoding vector. We add it to the patch embedding and send the result to the transformer encoder. This encoder is exactly the one described in Attention is All You Need paper. If you want to know more about its inner working, I recommend you watch my comprehensive video on the paper Attention is All You Need, in which I try to explain the transformer architecture in detail. One of the transformer outputs corresponds to the class token and will be sent to a softmax to classify the image. The rest of the outputs, on the other hand, are not important and we can get rid of them. So, this is how you train your vision transformer. If you'd like to fine-tune it for a downstream task, you simply remove the prediction head and attach a zero initialized feedforward layer instead. As you can see here, vision transformers perform better than a very big CNN-based network, while being faster and more efficient in the terms of computational costs. Transformer models also outperform CNN-based models on visual task adaptation benchmarks. So, does this mean we no longer need CNNs and can use transformers for computer vision tasks? Well, let's not rush into conclusions yet. As you can see in this figure, CNN-based models actually outperform every transformer model when we pre-train them with a small number of data. And in order to have transformer models that can beat CNN-based models, we need to train big transformers on enormous datasets. So if you are Google, you'd better put CNNs aside and use this new model. But if you are not Google, you still have to work with CNNs. Alternatively, you could use pre-trained vision transformer model and fine-tune it so it can perform well on your downstream task. In this video, I first describe one of the biggest flaws in attention mechanism, which is the fact that it is computation-hungry. Then I showed you how the authors of this paper get around this difficulty. We learned about vision transformer, a large model that can be fine-tuned for a variety of computer vision tasks. And we observed that, given enough data, vision transformer outperforms CNNs.
Thanks for watching. I hope you find this video educational and informative. If you like this video, please subscribe to my channel. See you in the next video.